Once upon a time, not so very long ago, there was a little boy named Randy and a little girl named Ellen who lived with their mother and father on a farm in the country. The last of the crops had been harvested weeks ago, and now the fields were blanketed with snow. And already it was the day before Christmas, the day father and mother had promised to drive Randy and Ellen to town so they could finish their Christmas shopping and visit Santa Claus. Randy and Ellen had looked forward to this day for a long time, and now that it had finally arrived, they were bursting with excitement. Randy had gotten up early and helped Father feed the livestock and clean out the barn. Ellen helped Mother do the dishes and make the beds, and then she picked up her room. As Randy and Ellen quickly finished their chores and prepared for their trip to town, giant snowflakes began to fall from the cold gray sky. The crisp north wind whistled and moaned as it swirled crystals of snow into the wooded countryside, creating a positively beautiful winter wonderland.
Hey, Dad!
Randy shouted enthusiastically.
Hey, Dad! Can we hitch up the horses and ride to town in the sleigh?
Father agreed, and soon the whole family was all snuggled together in the sleigh, riding merrily down winding country lanes, surrounded by trees and bushes that were beginning to hang heavy with snow. The cold December wind whipped through the trees until Randy and Ellen's cheeks and nose turned bright red, just like the bow on the Christmas wreath that Mother had hung on the front door at home. As they rode along, Randy and Ellen noticed the footprints of two frisky rabbits that had dashed through the trees and into the forest. Father explained that the tracks were fresh because they had not yet been covered by the falling snow. Later, they passed under an old covered bridge and into a forest clearing. There, at the bottom of a steep hill, was a pond covered with ice. Children of all ages were skating across it in smooth, gliding motions. Their brightly colored jackets and scarves reminded Ellen of the picture on a Christmas card that they had just gotten in the mail from Grandmother. Soon the horse-drawn sleigh jingled its way through the forest and into town. The streets were gaily decorated with red and green and blue and yellow lights strung through the gray, snow-swept sky. Carolers, bundled in their warmest clothing, were strolling from store to store, singing favorite songs of the Yuletide season. Randy and Ellen quickly finished their Christmas shopping, being very careful to choose just the right gifts for everyone on their lists. Randy even bought a wire brush for his pony Lightning, and Ellen picked out a rubber bone for their dog Bowser. Now, at last, that moment that all boys and girls look forward to, a visit with Santa Claus. Randy and Ellen scurried to the toy department, turned left at the game counter, and there he was, perched high in a cushioned chair, clad from head to toe in a bright red suit, sat Santa Claus. Randy and Ellen waited their turn, and then climbed up on his knees, Randy on the left knee and Ellen on the right knee. Santa's long, flowing white beard tickled Ellen's ear, and she couldn't help but giggle.
Oh, 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 Randy and Ellen, I wondered if you'd forgotten me this year,
laughed Santa.
Oh, no, Santa Claus,
said Ellen.
We could never forget you.
Tell me, Ellen,
asked Santa.
What do you want for Christmas?
I'd like a new doll and a toy electric sewing machine,
said Ellen,
so I can make new clothes for her.
Santa laughed.
Ho, ho, ho. And how about you, Randy? What shall I bring you this evening? It is Christmas Eve, you know.
Oh, yes, Santa,
said Randy.
We're really excited, too. I want an electric train with an engine that blows real smoke.
Randy, have you been helping your father with the chores?
Asked Santa.
And Ellen, do you help your mother wash the dishes and clean the house?
We try to help,
Randy replied.
But Santa, Ellen's worried.
Ho, ho, ho,
laughed Santa.
Ellen, Whatever could be bothering you on Christmas Eve?
Whatever could be bothering any boy or girl on Christmas Eve? You can find out by listening to the other side of this record.